Hello again, everybody. It's TJ, the Stereo Barbing Found. You all guessed it. I'm very pumped up today to finally bring you all the overview of the Audiolab 6000A. But first and foremost, I want to give a big thank you to Joe and American Audio and Video, a division of Jam Industries, for sending in the Audiolab 6000A so we could have an overview of it today. So big thank you to Joe, to American Audio Video, division of Jam Industries. And also, I highly recommend, if you're interested in buying the Audiolab 6000A, I highly recommend Audio Advisor. They are an awesome company. And down in the description box, I will tag their link if you're interested in ordering it. And first and foremost, today I'm going to go over a couple quick little specs. I'm not going to dig deep down into the specs. I will upload down in the description box Audiolab's website on the Audiolab 6000A. And then I'm going to go over a couple features. And then I'm going to give you all my subjective, humble opinion of the overall sound performance. In my opinion, of course. And I have many different speakers that I have paired it with. And first and after that, we'll have a close-up of the digital integrated amplifier. I will show you all the different features in the front and all the different knobs and what they do. And then at the end, I will, because you all know I've got to do it, I've got to pop the hood for you all. But anyways, first and foremost, I highly recommend nobody out there pop the hood theirself on their Audiolab 6000A. One, it can be very dangerous, even though you have the digital integrated amplifier unplugged and turned off. Inside of the integrated amplifier, there are high filter capacitors that can hold a charge, so you can be fatally injured. You could get electrocuted. I just want to go ahead and tell you all, I have over 30 years experience of opening up audio equipment. And second, if your Audiolab is still under warranty and you open it up, Audiolab, trust me, will know, and it will automatically void your warranty. So let's go ahead and get into this Audiolab 6000A digital integrated amplifier, because this isn't a normal digital integrated amplifier. I must go ahead and tell you all from the beginning, this amplifier retails in the United States for $999. So let's just call it $1,000. And to me, any integrated amplifier that's under $1,000 is a budget to me. But $1,000 is getting up there to the top price point. But this is not your everyday digital integrated amplifier. This is basically a 3-in-1. That's right. What do I mean by a 3-in-1? Well, you can use the Audiolab 6000A as a full-blown digital integrated amplifier, or you can use it as a dedicated preamp. And one thing Audiolab incorporated in this digital integrated amplifier is when you use it purely as a preamp and you go through the mode, it actually cuts off the amp section inside of the digital integrated amp. And that is a really nice feature to have, especially at its budget price point. You don't see this in a lot of budget integrated amplifiers. And what that helps do is keep the noise floor low. And it keeps from having more cross-contamination with radio frequencies inside one box. So that was really smart, Audiolab. Another and three, what you can use this digital integrated amp for is home theater bypass. That's right, for you people out there that don't have a lot of extra room. You know, you don't have an extra room to have, you know, a two-channel music setup, but you want that. Well, you can actually use the Audiolab 6000A with your home theater receiver. If your home theater receiver has front, left, and right front speakers pre-outs, you can run the pre-outs to the amp input of the Audiolab 6000A and your home theater receiver. Not only will it take stress off of it, but it will also control the volume from the Audiolab, because you will hook your front speakers straight into the Audiolab. And we will take a close look around everything for you all. But I thought that was a really cool feature. I hooked it up to my Marantz home theater receiver that does have them pre-outs, and it done a really good job. You know, especially this Audiolab 6000A is rated at 50 watts at 8 ohms and 75 watts at 4 ohms. And this is Audiolab's entry level integrated amplifier. But one thing I will say, you know, at that power rating that they give, they incorporated a really nice power supply. It comes with a 200 VA toroidal transformer. And get this, you all, 60,000 microfarad capacitance total. You got four high filter caps that are 15,000 microfarads each. And that allows you to store a lot of energy up. Not only that, I don't want to get into this deep, but it also helps out with the ripple effect. So that really gives you a lot of power on tap. And it really helps for those, you know, those dynamic peaks. Especially, you all know I'm a Yamaha fan. And I had a Yamaha AS801. And that Yamaha AS801 was rated at 100 watts. And it had 24,000 microfarad capacitance. But here we have the Audiolab 6000A rated at 50 watts at 8 ohms. And it has 60,000 microfarad capacitance. So that lets you know it's got a good meaty size power supply built inside of the Audiolab 6000A, which I will be popping the hood for you all to give you all a closer look at that. But I just think that's really cool how they incorporated all these features into this digital integrated amplifier. And it does come with a built-in DAC, which is the Sabre DAC, 32-bit reference DAC. It is the 9018 DAC chip, which is 24-bit and 192 kilohertz. But the special thing about the ESS DAC chip, the 9018, is when Audiolab came out with the Audiolab 6000A, that was in 2018. Now, Audiolab started dealing with this DAC chip all the way back in 2011 with their MDAC. So Audiolab's had a lot of time to perfect, you know, their circuitry and their power supply to the DAC. And I must admit, to be on a, you know, to be a budget integrated amplifier, the built-in DAC does sound really good. Over here on the right, I know you all can't see it in the video, but I have five budget DACs over here to my right. And I'll give you my humble, honest opinion. The built-in DAC, to me, sounds like, you know, all the way up to a $200 outboard DAC. And that is pretty impressive for its total price point of $1,000 US. And another thing, this antenna you see here in the back, it does have Bluetooth connect to it. And it is aptX. That's right, I use the aptX and the Bluetooth. When you do use the Bluetooth, it automatically uses the built-in DAC inside. And, you know, Bluetooth is very convenient. And some of the songs, I was really impressed. Really impressed with the DAC overall. Now, I didn't use the phono input, but a lot of people were talking about the JFITs that were met in the phono input of this Audiolab 6000A. They said it's better than decent for the price point. But yeah, that's about it. But I will go ahead and get to my overall subjective, humble opinion of the overall sound quality. And to me, in my humble opinion, it does have that British sound. So let's go ahead and start out with the low end. The low end bass. The bass is strong and stern with good speed and weight to it. It's very accurate bass that some would call articulate bass. The bass isn't overly muscular, but it is very meaty. But I would recommend you, when you're using this digital integrated amplifier, to have speakers that are at least 89 dB efficient and above. Now, speakers I had that were 89 dB efficient and above, the Audiolab 6000A had no problem driving them at all. Just to give you an instance, one of the best sounding speakers that I had that paired with good synergy for me with the Audiolab 6000A was right here to my left, the JBL Studio 580 Tower, which is rated at 90 dB efficiency. And I was shocked that when that kick drum would hit, you know, it was a good punch. No, it didn't punch me right upside the chest, but you know, it was a solid punch. It was quick and accurate. The bass is one of the star of the shows of this digital integrated amplifier, and it can draw up to 9 amps. And to be rated at 50 watts at 8 ohms and 75 watts at 4 ohms, it's pretty impressive bass. But anyways, now I want to get to the mid body, or what you all call the mid range. The mid range is very clean and clear sounding with a little bit of warmth to it. It has that smooth, mature, laid back sound, or what some people would call that relaxed, natural sounding. Now the top end, it has a sweetness to it that really projects out into the room. But the treble isn't, you know, overly forward or too harsh or too lively. To me, it is a little bit rolled off. And I tell you, this amp contains some very lively, bright sounding speakers that normally could be a little fatiguing to you, to anybody. But anyways, yes, that top end. Now, I've read up with some people said, you know, the top end, you know, not the high top end, but the mid top end and the low top end can be a little bit dry. But to me, it really wasn't dry. It was just a little bit rolled off, just to knock that edginess off. That way it didn't sound too sharp or too edgy or too bright or too much in your face. And, you know, it just really tamed my lively speakers. So, you know, this sound won't be for everybody, but it will be for a lot of people. And now I understand why there's so many fans of Audiolab. You know, Audiolab sound, you know, that British sound character, because it's really relaxing to listen to. And to me, you know, overall, it has just a really good, mature sound. Overall, it sounds really clean and clear with meaty, accurate bass. And the mid-range, you know, it's relaxed and laid back and just with a little bit of warmth to it. And that top end, you know, it's got that good sweetness to it, but it's not overly done treble. Now, one of the only caveats with the Audiolab 6000A that I came up with is that when you're going pure analog mode, there is no tone controls for the bass or treble. But I think Audiolab done an excellent job, you know, with the way it sounds purely. Now you can, when you're running the digital, because it does have two digital coax and two digital Toslinks plugins for the built-in DAC. Now the DAC, when I do a close-up, I will show you, it has three different filters. It has slow roll-off, phase, and fast roll-off. I preferred the slow roll-off overall. But if you have it, you'll just have to go through and match it up with your speaker synergy. But this is an amplifier. Once you do find the right speakers for it, it can sound really good. Now with my Klipsch over here to my right, my Klipsch Reference Premier 160 monitor speakers, I couldn't believe how well it paired up with this Audiolab 6000A. I mean, it used to be up in my face, and sometimes at long periods of listening times would be fatiguing to me. But the Audiolab 6000A, it tamed it. And to me, overall, it just has that mature, laid-back sound. Relaxed and natural sounding. But anyways, that's about my take on it. There's no fluff to it, no stuff. But, you know, when it comes to soundstage, you know, with my speakers, I have a lot of experience with my speakers. You know, it really didn't add no width to the soundstage, but it didn't take nothing away from it either. You know, some of my speakers that, you know, didn't have a lot of low-end bass at lower volumes, you know, it picked it up a little bit. And again, it's got meaty, accurate bass to it. It is not overly muscular. But, you know, I've done a lot of research on the Audiolab 6000A, and a lot of people out there owned it. I was reading up, and a lot of them recommended speakers like Monitor Audio, Focal speakers, Wharfdale speakers, Kef speakers. And, yes, it did sound good on the Kefs, but I like the overall sound better with the Audiolab 6000A with the Klipsch Reference Premier and the JBL Studio 580. I mean, it just really tamed that sound for me. But I'm really curious, because I got a lot of experience with speakers over the year. I would love to see how this solid state at 50 watts, you all, at 8 ohms and 75 watts at 4 ohms, I would love to see how it would pair with, you know, a little bit more expensive speaker like the Klipsch Forte 3 or the Klipsch Hershey 5s. I just have a feeling, I haven't heard it, I just have a feeling it could really tame the, you know, those large horn tweeters. And those speakers are already so, you know, efficient. They're like 90 dB efficient. I know this amplifier, for its price point at $1,000, I have a good feeling it would sound good on those speakers. But anyways, I'm going to go ahead and pause it right now because we're going to take a close-up look of the digital integrated amplifier. Hope I haven't missed out on anything. Oh, yes, before I forget, the dynamics. The dynamics overall with this amplifier was very impressive to be rated at 50 watts. The dynamics sounded more like a budget amplifier that was rated at 75 to 80 watts. I mean, the dynamics are really good, and I know that has something to do with the beefy power supply that Audiolab put inside with that 200 VA toroidal transformer and 60,000 microfarads capacitance. And the integrated amp can draw up to 9 amps. So let me go ahead and pause it real quick, and we'll take a close look, and then I will pop the hood for you all. Okay, here we are at the front of the digital integrated amp, and over here to our far left is our selector knob. The controls feel really good. Let me get this better in for you all. There you go, and as I go through the inputs, you will hear the relays open and close in the back. So here we go, and we have our OLED screen that I can see from far away. You hear it click. Well, I skipped a couple, but there's your phono, Bluetooth. Let me go back, auxiliary 1, Bluetooth, auxiliary 2, auxiliary 3, optical 1, optical 2, digital 1, digital 2. Now we're going to use the mode, and this, you will take it to just a dedicated preamp, or integrated amp, or pre-power amp, and you can hear the relays kick over, turning off the power amp and the preamp, depending on if you're using it as a preamp or a dedicated amp for the home theater bypass. So let's go ahead and put it back on integrated amp. Now we push this button in, you have balance and your filter. Push in for filter, slow roll off through the DAC, phase, and fast roll off through the digital DAC. When you go pure analog, there is no tone controls, and that may be a caveat for some people. Then we have our volume knob. It's got a nice click to it. Feels very well built. We start at 78 and goes all the way up to plus 8. And yes, here's the bigger headphone jack, and I will tell you, Audiolab did put in its own amplifier for headphones, and it sounded great with my Drop 6XX headphones. Here's the 3/4 inch jack, and when we plugged it in, it'll say headphones on. Here are the headphones I used, and it sounded great, very powerful, very surprising. And then we have our standby button to turn it on or to put it in standby mode. Now let's go to the back of the digital integrated amp. Okay, now that we're at the back of the digital integrated amp, we'll go to the far left side. You see we have the detachable power cord. Sorry, I just got off work, y'all. And up top, we have a toggle switch. We're off and on. And you can see above the power plug input, we have a fuse. So if anything goes wrong, it may first blow that fuse inside. Again, aptX, Bluetooth with your antenna. Here's our 5-way binding post. My banana plugs fit in there very tightly. And here we have our 12-volt trigger. Now here we have our 4 digital inputs. Top, you have optical 1 and optical 2 for your TOS link, or should I say Toshiba link.
And down on the bottom, we have digital 1, digital 2 for your coax. And here's where you update, or I've seen that Audio Lab also makes a network streamer that you can plug up here also. And if we go over to our RCA inputs, here you see pre-out on the first one. The second one, that is just your power amp. If you want to run, you know, another preamp to it, or your home theater bypass, this is where you would plug it up. Your pre-outs from your receiver would plug right into here. Then we have three analog inputs. Then on the end, we have our phono input in a nice metal ground. And one thing Audio Lab did is they incorporated JFETs in with their phono preamp. Very well built. As you can see, I already got the screws out of the back. There is 20 screws to take this apart to pop the hood for you all. And before I forget, here is the nice size remote, the same remote that came with my Audio Lab CDT-6000 that I actually bought, that I was so impressed with it. And you can see down here, you have your button for you to control the CD player by Audio Lab, the CDT-6000, the amp, and the network streamer. It's pretty cool. And now for one of my favorite parts of the whole video, I am going to pop the hood for you all, so I highly suggest nobody else do this. I'm doing this for you. It can automatically void your warranty, and it can be dangerous. So I'm going to go slow, and we're going to look at the whole inside. There's over 20 screws you got to take out to open this up. I highly recommend that you don't do that. Okay, this is my favorite part of the whole video. And I highly recommend that you don't pop the hood yourself. I have over 30 years experience popping the hood. So please don't do this, because it can be fatal and you can void your warranty. So let's go ahead and take a close look inside. And again, there's over 20 screws holding the cover on. And Audio Lab built this like a tank. So if we see over here, we have our nice size toroidal transformer. It's a 200 VA. I'm going to try to do this slow for you all, so you all can get a good look. As you can see, two massive heat sinks built very well. Ain't no flimsy tin. That lets you know the output stage transistors are probably warming up and they need to keep it cool. That's nice to see in an amplifier that is rated at 50 watts at 8 ohms. Are you serious? You know, you all, it is not how many watts your amplifier has, but it's actually the quality of them watts. So let's go back here and look at the high filter capacitors. I wanted to give you all a little bit better angle. They are 5. Yeah, really nice heat sinks. Again, there's those output stage transistors. I'm going to try to get that in better for you all. Nope, they got them just down in there right where I can't see them. Very good build quality, Audio Lab. So if we go back here in this section, this is actually your phono preamp with JFETs. A lot of people have bragged on this. Then we have our analog inputs, and then this one here would be your amplifier input, and this one here, your preamp's going to be under this board. So let's take a look at the preamp. They got the preamp board under here covered up really well, making it hard to see. But on top of that, here is our digital to analog converter, or DAC. Let's get a better view. Okay, here's our DAC board built inside. As you can see, Audio Lab done a very good job on that. We look down here, look at our speaker cable. That is good size speaker cable. I guess this would be our drivers on this side. Drivers there. But yeah, Audio Lab done a very, very good job. Very good build quality, Audio Lab. You get what you pay for. I must say, you all, this is very well built for its $1,000 budget price in the United States. Very good job, Audio Lab. So now it's time to go ahead and wrap this up. But to go ahead and wrap this up for you all, to me, overall, the amp sounds clean and clear with a meaty, accurate bass, articulate bass, with a smooth, relaxed mid-range with a sweet top end that's a little bit rolled off. Yes, it's just a little bit on the warm side of neutral. It's got very good dynamic peaks. No, the sound won't be for everybody, but it will be for a lot of people. Now I see why there's so many Audio Lab fans out there that love the Audio Lab sound. I will say, most of the time with your sound stage and your imaging, most of the time, you know, you get that from your speakers, but I have a lot of experience with my speakers, and I will say the Audio Lab 6000A, for being Audio Lab's entry level, you know, it the sound stage and the imaging was very good. It really didn't, you know, expand the sound stage, you know, a big difference with other budget integrated amplifiers. That was with one of the only caveats that I have, but you know, it did not take anything away either. Just a very well-built, integrated, digital integrated amplifier. Until next time, this is TJ, the Stereo Bargain Vow.